Hey guys, it's Matt with Rail Fan Depot. If you haven't guessed already, I'm in Strasburg, Pennsylvania. We're gonna check out the Railroad Museum, and then right across the street is the Strasburg Railroad. Let's go check it out. Man, wouldn't it be awesome to live down here? Whew. Right across the street. We'll check that out in a few. Just got checked in here at the Pennsylvania Railroad Museum. To check out this board back here is pretty cool.
So the board is from Newark, New Jersey.
Okay.
Newark, New Jersey Penn Station in the early 50s.
Okay, thank you. Pretty cool. It's been a while since I was here, 2001. Every time I come up here, they're always closed. Picked the wrong day. But man, they got a lot of stuff here. Beautiful GG1. This is definitely the best way to preserve inside this beautiful building they've built. This little 060 switcher. Very cool. I love how they did the corner of each of the buildings here. On this side, you can see Strasburg Railroad across the street. Hey, look at that. That's a shot right there. Really cool. Wow, I love how they got everything crammed in this big old room. Man, a lot of history here. Way to go, Pennsylvania, you did good. Tucked away over here in the corner, you might have heard me say this in some of my other videos, but there were three logging mountain type steam locomotives: the Chaise, the Climax, and the Heisler. Now, I took a gamble. I didn't walk over here before recording this. I didn't know if they were still over here, but that's the Chaise. That's my favorite. This is the good side too, in my opinion, with all the spindle and gears and everything down the side. I haven't been here since 2001, so thankfully they hadn't moved these. I was running a gamble by saying what I just said there. Yeah, over in this corner, there's the Climax. Each one of these were able to take a lot higher grades, a lot taller grades, I should say. There's the Heisler. Very cool. I've got videos of each of these style engines from Cass, West Virginia, if you want to go back and check out. Love that signal down there. I'd like to get one of those for my backyard. Shout out to my buddy Don. who's got a whole backyard full of fun like that. I know you're watching. So awesome. Along with the GG1, they've got a couple other electrified engines. A little switcher there. It's pretty cool. They have a cab just like that. That's a high nose, actually, at Roanoke. Museum of Transportation there in Roanoke. Railroad Museum. Caught a glimpse across the street, Strasburg Railroad, number 89. Getting right past the water tower. There it is. Live action. Like stepping back in time.
So all these trains.
This beautiful engine tucked away back here. 442. That looks nice. Wow. There goes Strasburg Railroad again across the street. They got a really cool yard out here too. It's closed today, unfortunately. Cool pieces out there too. I know I've said it before, but I would love to have one of these. Go out to some old abandoned rails and just ride. Check out this HO scale. Man, somebody put in some work. Looks really good. Turntable and roundhouse looks really nice. Yeah, like I said, unfortunately, yard's closed, but I would go out there if I could. Pretty cool plow back here in the corner. Let's check out the inside of 2846. Always like when they put the steps up here and you can come up here and check out everything in the cab. If you ever come here, definitely go across the bridge. Like I said, you gotta go across the bridge. It gives a different vantage point up here. This is, I don't remember this last time, but this is pretty cool, HO layout over here. It's actually operating. Somebody put in some work on this. Really nice. Well done. Cool. Back downstairs again. Those GG1s are massive. I wanted to check this out. You can go underneath of this engine. It's really cool. Now there's a perspective you don't see very often. Wow. Ash pan. Now we're under the tender. Very cool. You ever done that before, guys? Let's have a peek up inside of one of the passenger cars here. Wrap it up here and go across the street. See if we can see some live action at Strasburg. If you guys are ever in Strasburg, make sure you come on the day when the museum across the street is open. It is well worth the trip. Just outside of the Bird Museum, a couple other pieces that we can't get to. Behind fences. But now I'm across the street at Strasburg Railroad, where I really like this switch tower. We're waiting on the number 89 to come back from their excursion. Look around a little bit while it's away. Guys are ever on YouTube on Virtual Railfan, there's the Virtual Railfan camera right there. If you're ever wondering where it's at, oh, there's the sign for it right there. Look up on YouTube, Virtual Railfan Strasburg. Way off in the distance, I can see Thomas, the tank engine. In town for a couple of weekends of excursions. Kind of hard to see down there, but got the Strasburg switcher. Just pushed Thomas into the garage. Now the switcher's out on the main line again. All right, here comes number 89. I can hear the whistle way off in the distance down there. Getting ready to pass the Red Caboose Motel. And if you've never been there, you gotta check that place out. My family and I had stayed there a couple years ago. Every time we come up here, we try to stay there. Highly, highly worth the trip. The caboose have been refurbished inside, most of them. And you can get a double queen, or you can get a queen with bunk beds. It's actually really fun. It's right next to the tracks too. They got a really nice restaurant there too. Very good food. Red Caboose Motel. Hear that whistle?
Thank you.
take on some water and go to the shed for the day. Putting the shed for the evening. Got to see it take on water a little bit. Very cool. Live action. We got a really cool souvenir shop here and toy store. They have three different steam locomotives here, including the decapod. I like the decapod too. But if you guys are ever coming through Strasburg, definitely make sure you come on the day when you can go to the Pennsylvania Railroad Museum and Strasburg Railroad, and maybe even ride on the train. As always, guys, I appreciate each and every one of you. If you would, give me a thumbs up and subscribe. Go ahead and check out a couple of other videos. We got a bunch from Strasburg and a whole bunch of other steam locomotive videos. Check them out while you can. So maybe we'll stay here a little bit. Hang on. I'll go put some coal in them. I've seen them do that before. They run right up on that ramp there with a bucket loader and throw it right back in the back of the tender. All right, guys, thanks again.